Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I hope you all are fine. How was your Eid? People enjoy? Okay. In the previous lecture, I gave you some homework. How many of you did it? Those who have done, kindly raise your hands. Okay. Now, very nice. Okay. We have done with first unit of our English lab. In the English A portion. Today we are going to do some work in B portion. Clear? Okay. So for that you must have your rough registers, your pencils, your markers, your pointers, ink pens, each and everything. You should have all your stationaries in front of you. Okay. So those who have, raise your hand so that I can start. Alright. So today we are going to do two topics. One is pair of words and the other is proverbs. Clear? Means aaj hum do topics cover karenge, inshallah. Ek hai pair of words and the other one is proverbs. Now, what is pair of words? Before moving towards the writing and before moving towards the exercise or kaam shuru karne se ya writing karne se pehle, let me tell you what are pair of words. Do you know what is a pair? Joda jise kehte hai na? Just like we're having pair of socks, pair of shoes, isn't it? Jahan pe cheeze do mein ho. Clear? When we have two things. So that is called pair. Now what are pair of words? Pair of words, the first point of pair of words is they are homonyms. Now what is homonyms? Homo means same and names means name. Means those words which have same sounds, clear, but they are different in spellings and they are different in meaning, clear? Jab pronunciation same hoti hai, clear? When we are pronouncing a word, so those two words whose pronunciation is same, but they are different in meaning and they are different in spellings, clear? Pronunciation dono ki same hoti hai, but कहां पे डिफरेंस होता है स्पेलिंग उनकी डिफरेंट होती है एंड मीनिंग डिफरेंट होती है क्लियर जस्ट लाइक लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल जब हम बात करते हैं तो एक्सेप्ट और एक्सेप्ट क्लियर एक्सेप्ट भी एक्सेप्ट प्रोनाउंस करता है एंड एक्सेप्ट भी एक्सेप्ट प्रोनाउंस करता है क्लियर बट एक एक्सेप्ट इज कबूल करना एंड द अदर एक्सेप्ट इज बजाए या सिवाय क्लियर So let's move towards the writing. Now you should give proper heading, topic, write it with marker, okay? Now the choice is all yours, whether you want to write it with black marker or you want to write it with blue marker. Clear? So write topic with marker. And as you all know that whatever we are writing with the marker, so we should underline it with a pencil, isn't it? So underline topic with a pencil. And then in the second line, exactly below the topic, write the pair of words. Means the topic which we are going to do is that is pair of words. So write pair of words with the marker and then underline it. Clear? All of you have done? Raise your hands. Okay. So if you have done proper margin lines and underlining and all these things are done? Good. Now, you should draw four lines. One is for serial number, clear? Serial number. The other one is for words. The second line should be for English meanings, mean the word which we are going to do is what is their English meaning, okay? And the Urdu meaning, I will tell you orally. And then you are supposed to use the same word in the sentence, clear? Okay, so the first one word is die, D-I-E, die. And the second word, see, this is one pair of, okay? This is die and this is also die. Die and die, clear? So this die means mar jana, stop living, clear? And this die is to color something. Jab hum kisi cheez ko rang dete hain, rangna, clear? So see, both of them are having the same sound, same pronunciation, die, and die, but what is the difference? The difference is both of them are having the same spellings, and the same meaning. So the first one, die, means stop living, mar jana. Clear? So the sentence which I made here is better to die with honor than live with shame. Now better, acha hai ki banda izzat se mare. Honor means izzat. Keep one thing in your mind, you are not supposed to pronounce it as honor. The H here is silent. Clear? So better to die with honor than live with shame. Beizzati ki zindagi se acha hai ki banda izzat ki maut mare. Done? And keep one thing in your mind. In the previous lectures, we did capital letters, capitalization. So the start of the sentence, the B is capital. And then we did full stops as well. So the end of the sentence is, there's a full stop at the end. Means the sentence is finished here. Clear? Now, the same word of another word of the same pair is dye, to color. When you color something, jab aap kisi cheez ko rangte ho, clear? So she wants to dye her hair. Okay, now keep one thing in your mind. We are the singular of hair is also here, and the plural of hair is also here, clear? We are not saying it as hairs. This is wrong, okay? So she wants to dye her hair. Doesn't mean that she wants to dye her only one hair. Means she wants to dye her full hair. Clear? We are talking about hair. We are talking about more hair. Yahan pe hum bahut zyada baalon ki baat kar rahe hain. Clear? Okay. So she wants to dye her hair. Wo apne baal rangna chahti hai. Wo apne baal color karna chahti hai. Clear? So the two words, the pronunciation is same. The meaning is different and the spelling is also different. Clear? Now the second pair of word is for, F-O-R. So when we are using for? We are using for indication. Jab hum koi indication karte hai na, kisi ko wo dete hai, indication usko kehte hai. Jab aap kisi ko koi cheez point out karte ho, like for example, I waited at the bus station for 5 hours. Clear? So here it is the indication that I waited for this much time. Itne time ke liye maine wait kiya. Clear? So here the for, F-O-R, and the other pair of this, the other word of this pair is for. That is the mathematics one, for. 1, 2, 3, 4. Char wala jo for hota hai. Theek hai? So, clear? Here the for is, Urdu meaning is ke liye. I want to take this gift for my teacher. Main apni teacher ke liye gift lekar jana chahti hun. So here, this is a indication. Clear? Indication kya hoti hai? Kis ke liye lekar jana hai? Teacher ke liye. Clear? Okay. Now, the first one sentence is, I waited at the station for 5 hours. Again, here, H is silent. And then there's full stop at the end, means the sentence is finished over here. And I is capital because it is the starting of the sentence. Now four means four, 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, mathematics wala four, char. So she got 4 gold medals. Clear? Means 4 times she topped her class and she got 4 gold medals. When we top our class, so we get some medal or some prize or, you know, the trophy. So she got 4 gold medals. Clear? And then again, there's a full stop at the end. Okay. The third pair of words is by. By. By means bazariya. Clear? Identifying the thing, performing an action. Hum kaha, jaise hame pata chalta hai. For example, Sara goes to school by bus. So Sara school kis tarah jati hai? She goes to school by bus or she goes to school by cycle. Or she goes to school by walk. Theek hai na? So this by is telling us the zariya, that how she's traveling. Clear? It is identifying us the thing, that how she's traveling to school. Kaise wo school jaati hai? Clear? So see, by and by, both of them are having the same pronunciation. Clear? But what is difference is the spelling is the different. The spelling is different and the meaning is different. This one by is bazariya, and the second one buy, B-U-Y, is when you buy something, kharidna. Clear? So by identifying the thing performing the action, Sarah goes to school by bus, and then there's a full stop at the end. Now, buy, B-U-Y, when buy means obtain in exchange for payment, means when you get something in return of the payment, when you pay something, when you pay for something and then you take it, means when you purchase something, purchasing hoti hai na. So how we used to purchase the things from the school canteen? We used to give money to the canteen one person and then he used to give us biscuits or chips or something. So that is called the process of buying. Buy. Clear? Obtain in exchange of for payment means when we obtain something in exchange for payment. Means when we pay, jab hum paise de rahe the aur hume koi cheez mil jati hai. So that is called buying. Okay? Where did she buy this book? See, his did. So as there's did in the sentence, there is the first form of the verb. Where did she buy this book? Means usne ye kitab kahan pe khareedi? Here we are talking about past, and then as the starting of the sentence is where, WH. The word is WH, now verb. Where? So these are the questioning words. So don't forget to put the question mark at the end of the sentence, starting with what, where, when, why. Okay. So where did she buy this book? And then there's a question mark at the end. Everybody's clear till here? Raise your hands. Okay. Now, the fourth one is, again, this is the pair of words, two words we are having here. One is weak and the other one is also weak. But what is the difference is weak, weak. Here we are having double E, weak. A period of 7 days means hafta, jise hum kehte hain, jo 7 dinon pe mushtamil hota hai. So that is called weak. That is the double E-K one, week. Weak, weak. So the period of 7 days, clear? Hafta. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, clear? So we are having an oral test this week. Means this week, is hafte ko hamara oral test hai. The teacher will conduct the oral test. Clear? Now, the second word of this pair is weak, W-E-A-K. The pronunciation is same. Again, I'm telling you, the pronunciation is same, but where's the difference? The difference is the spelling and the different meaning. Clear? So weak, this one weak, E-A-K, one weak is kamzor. Lacking strength and energy, jab aap mein power nahi hota, jab aap mein energy nahi hoti, jab aap mein taakat nahi hoti, theek hai? So this weak is kamzor. He was a little weak after the surgery. Surgery. Now, what is a surgery? Surgery is operation. Kehte na ki he did surgery or she did surgery. So he was a little weak after the surgery. Means when he did the operation, after that surgery, he was weak. Definitely, bande pe takleef guzar jati hai to kya ho jati hai? Weakness aa jati, okay? Now, the fifth one is one and one. One and one. Now, the first one, one is the mathematics one, one. One, two, three, wala, one, ek. Clear? And the second one, one, W-O-N, is it's the past participle of which one word? Win. Clear? Now, I can't see the sentence. Let me... Okay, the fifth one, the first one word is one, one. She was the one who helped Ali. Means there were lots of people, okay, in the crowd maybe, and she was the only one. Ek wo akeli thi jisne Ali ki madad ki. Clear? And the second word of this pair is one. I told you before that it is the past participle of win. Clear? And its Urdu meaning is Jeet liya, means we are talking about past. We are talking about something that has already happened. Jo guzar chuka hai, clear? His daughter won an award for getting the top marks. Means, uski beti ne award jeeta kis pe? Top karne pe, clear? Okay, now proverbs. First one pair of words topic is done. All of you are clear till here? If yes, then kindly raise your hands. Okay, now we are moving towards the next topic, and that is proverb. Simply जो हम उर्दू में कहते हैं ना कहावत, कहते हैं ना हम लोग कि बहुत बड़ी मशहूर कहावत है, ये ऐसे था वो वैसे था. So that is basically proverb. So the proverb Urdu meaning is कहावत. Now what is a कहावत? What is a proverb? It is a simple, well-known traditional saying that expresses truth based on common sense. हम कहते हैं ना कि वो कोई इस तरह नहीं होता कि कोई हार्ड एंड फास्ट रूल नहीं होता कि आप उसको मानो, बट क्या होता है, ये कोई ट्रेडिशनल सेइंग होती है हमारे फोर फादर्स ने या उनसे भी पहले किसी ने की होती है. ठीक है, कैसे की होती है, कॉमन सेंस, उन्होंने ऑलरेडी वो प्रॉब्लम फेस की होती है या ऑलरेडी वो लोग उस सिचुएशन से गुजरे होते हैं. सो सिंपल उसको कहावत कहते हैं, मीन्स के उन्होंने उसको मतलब बजाय ये कि आप पूरा सिनेरियो अपने अल्फाज में बयान करें, आप सिंपली एक स्टेटमेंट, एक सेंटेंस आप कह देते हो. ठीक है, के मतलब जिस तरह से हम कहते हैं ना कि नीम हकीम खतराए जान. सो रादर देन सेइंग लाइक दिस दैट के उसके पास इतना एक्सपीरियंस नहीं था या वो इतना टैलेंटेड नहीं था या उसने इतना गेन नहीं किया था, तो जस्ट हम कह देते हैं कि बस नीम हकीम खतराए जान के सिंपल उसके पास लिटिल नॉलेज था, ही वॉज नॉट एबल टू प्रूव हिमसेल्फ, सो ये कह देते हैं. या अक्सर हम हमारी और भी बहुत ज्यादा कहावतें हैं. ओके, सिंपल अ शॉर्ट सेंटेंस दैट पीपल कोट विद व्हाइल गिविंग एग्जांपल. जब हम लोग कोई एग्जांपल देते हैं ना किसी को, तो क्या करते हैं, हम कोई प्रोवर्ब उसमें कोट कर लेते हैं. क्लियर? नाउ यू आर सपोज टू डू लाइक दिस इन योर कॉपी. ओके, गिव हेडिंग टॉपिक, राइट इट विद मार्कर एंड अंडरलाइन इट. ओके, and what is the topic? The topic is proverbs. Okay, so we are going to do 10 proverbs today. We will just do 5. Okay, hurry up, draw proper margin lines, underlining, hurry up. Okay, the first one is aankh ojal pahad ojal. See, can you see? Aankh ojal pahad ojal, this is the Urdu one kahawat. Okay, and the English proverb for this is out of sight, out of mind. Jab koi cheez hamare samne nahi hoti hai na, to hum kya karte hain, hum use bhool jate hain. Out of sight, out of mind. Jab koi cheez aapke samne nahi hoti hai to aap bhool jate ho na. जब कोई चीज आपके नजरों से दूर होती है तो ऑटोमेटिकली वो आपके माइंड से भी निकल जाती है, आपके दिमाग से भी निकल जाती है. क्लियर? ओके, द सेकेंड वन इज नीम हकीम खतराए जान. नीम मीन्स हाफ. हकीम, यू कैन टेक डॉक्टर, और जिस तरह हकीम होते हैं, यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दैट एज वेल. खतराए जान मीन्स जब बंदा प्रॉपरली एक्सपर्ट नहीं होता तो ऐसे डॉक्टर के पास हम जाते हैं, जब उसके पास एक्सपीरियंस नहीं होता या वो अभी मेडिकल के फर्स्ट ईयर या सेकंड ईयर या थर्ड ईयर में होता है, तो हम जाते हैं उसके पास कि हमें कोई हमारा कोई इलाज करे. नो, व्हाई? बिकॉज अभी वो पूरा हकीम नहीं होता, नीम हकीम होता है. सो द इंग्लिश प्रोवर्ब फॉर दिस इज अ लिटिल नॉलेज इज अ डेंजरस थिंग. क्लियर? जब आपके पास किसी टॉपिक के हवाले से या किसी चीज पे आपके पास फुल फ्लेज इलम नहीं होता, तो बजाय इसके कि आप उस टॉपिक पे बहस करें किसी के साथ, तो इट्स गुड कि आप तो क्या हो, खामोश रहें. क्लियर? क्योंकि क्या होता है कि हमारे पास, हम ऐसे टाइम पे एडवाइस नहीं देते हैं. जब हमें फुल फ्लेज एक चीज का इलम नहीं होता तो उस टाइम पे हम क्या करते हैं, हम एडवाइस नहीं देते किसी को भी, मशवरा नहीं देते. क्लियर? ओके, द थर्ड वन इज आप भले तो जग भला. गुड माइंड गुड फाइंड मीन्स when you are जब हम खुश होते हैं तो हमें सब चीजें हमें अच्छी लगती है ना. क्लियर? और जब हम ना खुश होते हैं तो चाहे अगला बंदा कितना भी अच्छा क्यों ना हो, हमें अच्छा नहीं लगता. मीन्स के आप भले तो जग भला, मीन्स के हम जब अच्छे होते हैं तो क्या होता है, हमें सब कुछ अच्छा लगता है. ओके, द फोर्थ वन इज जैसा देश वैसा बेस. When in Rome, do as Romans do. हम अक्सर ये कहते हैं ना कि जब अक्सर कोई आपने देखा होगा न्यूज वगैरह में कि जब इंग्लैंड वगैरह से या बाहर के ममालिक में से कोई भी उनका कोई आ जाता है, कोई नुमाइंदा, ठीक है, जो अपनी कंट्री को रिप्रेजेंट करता है, तो अक्सर लड़कियां यहाँ पे आके फिर कमीज शलवार पहन लेती है ना, rather than staying in pant shirt and all these things. So why? Because jaisa des waisa bes. When in Rome, do as Romans do. Jab aap kisi jagah pe chale jao, theek hai, to aapko chahiye ki aap wahan ke customs, wahan ke traditions ko follow kare. Clear? Rather than showing this ki main to yahan se hu and main to wahan se hu, and it's like no, jahan pe aap jate ho to wo custom, wo traditions aap follow karo jahan pe aap ho. Okay. The fifth one is ek mayan mein do talwarein nahi sama sakti. One man cannot serve two masters. No man can serve two masters. Okay. मतलब जब एक बंदा होता है तो वो कभी भी दो जो उनके मास्टर्स जो वो होते हैं यू कैन चेक के जो हुक्मरान होते हैं तो कभी भी कोई एक बंदा दो हुक्मरानों की नहीं मान सकता. क्लियर? क्यों? क्योंकि फिर उसमें वो खराब हो जाती है वो चीज. या तो वो किसी एक को लाइक करेगा दूसरे को डिसलाइक करेगा, या एक ही मानेगा दूसरे की नहीं मानेगा. क्लियर? सो एक मयान में दो तलवारें नहीं समा सकती. ओके नाउ This was enough for today. Now come towards the homework. Bachche, note down your homework. Okay, the homework is use the following pair of words in your own sentences. Theek hai, aapko main do pair of words de rahi hu, that is your homework. The one is dear and dear. Dear and dear. The one is animal and the other one is jo pyara hota hai aapka, my dear friend. Clear? So you have to write the English meaning, you have to write the Urdu meaning, and then you have to use both of them in the sentence. The second one is H and 8. 8, E-I-G-H-T, 1-8 is the 5, 6, 7, 8 mathematics, 1-8, and the other 1-8 is the past participle of eat, khaya. Clear? So you have to use both of them in the sentence. Okay, now, any question? If yes, kindly raise your hands.